everybody. I am Disha from class 5A, Delhi Public School, Vasant Vihar. Welcome to my comprehensive presentation called An Illustrated History of Computers. The first computers were people, that is, electronic computers, and the earlier mechanical computers were given this name because they performed the work that had previously been assigned to people. Computer was originally a job title. It was used to describe those human beings, predominantly women, whose job it was to perform the repetitive calculations required to compute such things as navigational tables, tide charts, and planetary positions for astronomical almanacs. Imagine you had a job where hour after hour, day after day, you had to do nothing but to compute multiplications. Boredom would quickly set in, leading to carelessness, leading to mistakes. And even on your best days, you would not be producing answers very fast. Therefore, inventors have been searching for hundreds of years for a way to mechanize and automate this task. This slide shows two pictures. The one on the top shows what were known as counting tables. The lower one shows a typical computer operation back when computers were people. The abacus was an early aid for mathematical computation. Its only value is that it aids the memory of the human performing the calculation. A skilled abacus operator can work on addition and subtraction problems at the speed of a person using a hand calculator. Multiplication and division are slower. The abacus is often wrongly attributed to China. In fact, the oldest surviving abacus was used in 300 BC by the Babylonians. The abacus is still in use today, principally in the Far East. A modern abacus consists of rings that slide over rods, but the older one pictured above dates from the time when pebbles were used for counting. The word calculus comes from the Latin word for pebble. This slide shows a more modern abacus. Note how the abacus is really just a representation of the human fingers. The five lower rings on each rod represent the five fingers, and the two upper rings represent the two hands. In 1617, an eccentric, some say mad, Scotsman named John Napier invented logarithms, which are a technology that allows multiplication to be performed via addition. The magic ingredient is the logarithm of each operand, which was originally obtained from a printed table. But Napier also invented an alternative to tables where the logarithm values were carved on ivory sticks, which are now called Napier's bones. The upper picture in this slide shows an original set of Napier's bones. The lower one shows a more modern set of Napier's bones. Napier's invention led directly to the slide rule, first built in England in 1632 and still in use in the 1960s by the NASA engineers of the Mercury, Gemini, and Apollo programmers, which landed men on the moon. Just imagine, simple slide rule and men landing for the first time on the moon. Leonardo da Vinci, who lived from 1452 to 1519, made drawings of gear-driven calculating machines, but apparently never built any. Here is a Leonardo da Vinci drawing showing gears arranged for computing. The first gear-driven calculating machine to actually be built was probably the calculating clock, so named by its inventor, the German professor William Schackard, in 1623. This device got little publicity because Schackard died soon afterward in the bubonic plague. This picture is of Schackard's calculating clock. In 1642, Blaise Pascal, at age 19, invented the Pascaline as an aid for his father, who was a tax collector. Pascal built 50 of this gear-driven one-function calculator. It could only add, but he could not sell many because it was very costly and they really were not that accurate. At that time, it was not possible to fabricate gears with the required precision. Up until the present age, when car dashboard went digital, the odometer portion of the car's speedometer used the very same mechanism as the Pascaline to increment the next wheel after each full revolution of the prior wheel. Pascal was a child prodigy. At the age of 12, he was discovered doing his version of Euclid's 32nd proposition on the kitchen floor. Pascal went on to invent probability theory, the hydraulic press, and the syringe. Here is a picture of Pascal's Pascaline. This is another picture of a 6-digit model for those who could not afford the 8-digit model. This slide shows a Pascaline opened up so you can observe the gears and cylinders which rotated to display the numerical results.